and you are looking live at a Falcon 9 rocket on the launch pad at the Cape Canaveral Air Force Station in Florida. At 12:51 this afternoon, the aerospace company SpaceX will launch a Dragon cargo spacecraft on a NASA mission to resupply the International Space Station. Good afternoon and welcome everyone to NASA's Kennedy Space Center for our live coverage of the launch of the 19th resupply mission for SpaceX. I'm your host, Jennifer Wolfinger. We are about 28 minutes away from the planned liftoff of a Falcon 9 rocket from the coast of Florida. The mission? To fly much-needed astronaut supplies and research experiments up to the International Space Station. And we have a team of correspondents across the country helping us cover all the angles of this launch. We will head to the Mission Director Center here on the Space Coast to get updates on the weather and the countdown. And we'll head west to SpaceX headquarters in Hawthorne, California, and check in at Mission Control Houston at Johnson Space Center. But first, here are some quick facts about today's launch. SpaceX transported the Falcon 9 rocket out to the launch pad and lifted it to the vertical launch position for the 19th cargo resupply mission to the International Space Station. This is the third flight for this Dragon spacecraft and the first time this Falcon booster has been flown. Dragon will deliver more than 5,700 pounds of astronaut supplies and payloads for science research to the orbiting laboratory. The launch window today is instantaneous, which means SpaceX must launch at the exact second for the planned liftoff or try again another day. The plan is to keep the Dragon spacecraft docked to station for about a month before bringing it back to Earth. The Dragon spacecraft will be filled with critical materials to directly support science and research that will take place on the International Space Station. Dragon will carry the confined combustion investigation, which examines the behavior of flame as it spreads in differently shaped confined spaces and microgravity. Understanding how fire spreads and behaves in space is crucial for the safety of astronauts and for understanding and controlling fire here on Earth. Another exciting payload is the Hyperspectral Imager Suite, which is a next-generation hyperspectral Earth imaging system developed by the Japanese government. It provides space-based observations for tasks such as resource exploration and applications in agriculture, forestry, and other environmental areas. The Mighty Mice in Space, or Rodent Research 19 investigation, will research features that influence muscle degradation to prevent skeletal muscle and bone loss during spaceflight and enhance recovery following return to Earth. This study could also support the development of therapies for a wide range of conditions that cause muscle and bone loss.